In Canada, this is progress.
I'm going in deep and it does burn.
Just hospital caliber testing virtually anywhere you need it. Just roll down your car window.
Yeah, I definitely feel that.
This is my first time getting tested. It made it extremely not intimidating. Like, I feel like I could come back if I needed to, for sure.
I like it because everyone's really prepared and I don't even have to get out of my car.
And sure enough, when the Grand River Hospital in Kitchener, Ontario made the switch from walk-in to drive-thru,
we would see between 175 and 200 patients a day in the hospital, and then we moved to the drive-thru testing center and we're able to process at least 400 cars a day on average now.
More than double.
More than double, yeah. Lots of symptomatic people today?
Yeah, lots.
But Dr. Jay Green and his team, despite having done more than 30,000 tests on this site to date.
And Dr. Green.
No, this is still just the tip of the innovation iceberg.
No fever.
Because this model has one fundamental flaw.
I'll give that a B to a C, right? A drive-through, you still gotta wait. You're gonna have to wait for results. Our ability to understand how disease is spreading in the community is totally limited by patients coming forward to assessment centers and getting tested. We need to do better than that.
Dr. Andrew Morris is an infectious diseases specialist at Toronto's Mount Sinai Hospital, and he also teaches at the University of Toronto's Medical School.
I think the gold standard where we really need to be is that people can get tested when they want to be tested, and more importantly, where they can be tested that's convenient for them.
So here's what's possible when you allow people like these university students to take testing into their own hands.
It was like super easy. You just have to spit into a tube, 5 milliliters, and it wasn't that bad.
It was definitely a bit easier and a lot quicker.
Saliva-based testing like this is widely seen as the future. The samples analyzed at the University of South Carolina's own lab, with results coming in 24 hours. Data this fast is powerful, and the technology is already here. You just can't use it yet. This is one saliva-based test submitted to Health Canada for review. It's from a company called Diacarta. It can be done anywhere by anyone because it doesn't require a nurse or a doctor to administer. And it's pretty simple. You spit into the tube. Once you've collected enough saliva, you would mix the results with a preserved liquid that they send to you as well. You cap it off, you seal it up, and then you mail that to a lab and you wait for your results. The FDA in the United States has already approved this for emergency use, but here in Canada, it's still under review.
I think it's really important that Health Canada does take their time, but on the other hand, I do think that they need a phase shift in terms of how they're thinking about diagnostic testing.
Health Canada has taken a much more cautious approach to testing than the United States. One concern, accuracy, but also user error.
The idea that people can't really be trusted to do the job of a health professional. What do you think about that? Well, I do believe that people can't be trusted to do the job of a health professional, but we can't keep on thinking that all of these tests are the job of health professionals. If we rely on people to make decisions based on whether they have a sore throat or a fever, at least we should be able to ask them to make decisions on whether a test is positive or negative and how to act on that appropriately.
And in labs across the country, researchers racing to design better and better tests.
This part of the device will go in the mouth.
At the University of Saskatchewan, they're developing a saliva test that can deliver near instant results, and you can use it at home.
If the patient has COVID-19, this device is gonna change their color to red.
At the moment, we are working the size and the shape of a pregnancy test.
Dr. Walter Sequeira is leading the development of this test.
If we have a test that the person can do in half an hour to 1 hour, and if it's negative, the person can come to the college, the person can come to work. And so this is something that is, I can see that could be a game changer here.
But these things take time. His best guess when the device might be in operation? 2021. Back at the drive-thru, easy to see how a spit test would be a game changer.
If it was something like saliva test, do you think that would change how often you get tested?
Yeah, if I felt it was just spitting in a tube, something as simple as that and painless, I would probably be more up for it.
If the saliva tests work, then we should do more of it then.
I feel like a lot of people are terrified of the idea of the nose, like the invasion of the nose. Spitting in the tube would definitely be a lot easier.
We need to be able, with more confidence, to open up our society. And we're not going to be able to open up our society until we either have herd immunity through vaccination, or we're able to dramatically reduce the risk of infections entering into congregate settings, and that's going to be through diagnostic testing.
Right, because the price of not being more ambitious with testing is what?
I think it's going to be prolonged lockdowns, prolonged social isolation, and really, you know, the life that we're leading right now, it's going to be very, very difficult for us to ease up any further restrictions unless we, you know, improve on how we do our surveillance.